Hey, what's up, guys? It's me, Brandon Johnson from Used Boats TV, and today I have the pleasure of showing you a beautiful 2005 Harris 230 SX Super Sunliner Triton. So we're back at you today to show you this beautiful Tritune. I've actually sold this to the last two owners. This is a 300 boat from here at the Lake of the Ozarks since brand new. He is actually selling this one, and then I sold the Sea Ray right here a couple weeks ago. My dog is on the neighbor's dock. Sorry about that. Sarge, get over here. Anyhow, we've been picking up some boats lately, and we're getting those cleaned up to get them listed to make some more videos. Our trailer business has been incredible, but I just really wanted to stop for a moment here before I show you the exterior and the interior and just thank you. I had so many people comment, call, text, email, send cards, supporting our decision to go out on our own at Used Boats TV, and it just means a lot to me, a lot. So thank you guys so much. We're going to start looking at the outside of this boat. Remember, our website is usedboatstv.com, which will redirect you to firstphasemarine.com to see our inventory. Gladstone Cove Boat Trailer Sales.com is our trailer business. And the buttseatspray.com has our custom boating goods. Let's get started looking at this bad gal.
Wow. This is a nice boat.
Taking a look at the exterior, we have a ski tow bar. So that's something to point out. Some of these don't even have them. You don't know until you're going to ski and there's nowhere to tie up the rope. This bad gal's got a 150 Yamaha 4-stroke stainless steel prop. It does have a live well. That's where the aerator's right there. And it's got the bigger pontoons. So it's got 25-inch logs. So we got a little crinkle back here. Comments box, the fuel tank's here. Oddly enough, that one's not broke. So you're always going to have a little bit of that. Graphics are a little worn off. Those are just stickers. If you want it to look brand new, I actually have a graphic guy that can make whole new replacement panels that are, you know, vinyl graphics go along the whole side. Looks incredible. So we have an entry door right here. Rubber rub rail, give you a little extra bounce. Coming on along the front. So since it's got the oversized pontoons and lifting strakes, you know, the front end's not all bashed in, it really handles rough water well. This is a Brunswick product, built exceptionally good. Lifting strakes, heated underbelly, aluminum cross channels, all the good, cool stuff that people that are showing you crappy ones don't want you to know. So we got some cleats up here. We kind of got a, oh shit, what happened right there? Bump into the dock. They make these rubber fingers that you can put on there that are awesome. And then you don't have to worry about hanging buoys. So it does have a full cover. Now this is a 3-owner boat and I've sold to the last two owners. It's got the deep reaching stainless steel aft ladder so you can get into the back. I always say buying one without rear entry is, you know, it's almost resale suicide unless you have family members that you just absolutely don't want little kids getting back there by the motor. Now let's jump inside the interior and take a look.
Hey Dad, that's a cool whip.
So as we take a look at the interior, it's in really nice shape. So typically up here at the front of the boat towards the bow, you would have your fencing that would come around to a point and you'd have a bit of a flat deck out here. So a lot of people actually have misconception that you lose seating when you have these two fishing seats up front. And sure, I mean, it's got some fishing features, but these are super comfortable plush seats. Whether you like to fish or not, this is a great spot to just kick your feet out and really enjoy yourself. So anyhow, you gain two seats, you don't lose two seats with this seating configuration. But for those of you that do like to fish, it has the half gate for the live well, half gate for the live well, half gate for the trolling motor with the plug wiring underneath this seat over here or that seat, but it doesn't have a trolling motor with it. You got storage compartments on both sides for tackle coming along towards the midship. All the vinyl's in really nice shape. Now you're gonna see some spots, and this happened on every one of these Harrises where they had like a chrome sticker that went on the seats and it always fell off. But these are rotocast seat bases, not plywood boxes, so you don't have to worry about rot. Here's your live well right here, your fill. Now this is a great idea. Not, you know, hanging a trash can in a pontoon boat sucks. So this is oversized, great big, sits right down into here. For alcoholics, I engineered a great thing to get more beer cans in them. take a box knife and cut the bottom out of your trash can. Allows you to put a lot more beer cans in. You're welcome, boat manufacturers. I'm here all night. So we just have storage underneath this seat, and I love the way these hinge out, so you don't have to worry about getting in and out of there. It's got nice layback, stainless steel cup holders. Down the floor, we have ski storage on a full piano hinge, which is obviously a Brunswick thing. It's a nice, thick, heavy lid. This is a four-door model, front, sides, back. Coming back even more so midship towards the helm, we have a nice storage compartment right here. This has a little hand pump sink. If you choose to use it, obviously, you know, Chuck didn't use it. So you put a little tank or just a gallon of water in here, put the hose in, hand pumps it in. This is another storage compartment. You can also slide in like a 26 quart Igloo marine cooler in here. This is a full fiberglass helm, very nice. Starboard composite inserts for your storage compartments. More storage underneath this seat. Custom table he made for his wife. Cup holders slide out. You can make it bigger. Isn't that awesome? I think it's really cool. L-shaped seating. So a lot of you will wonder, well, where's the changing room if that's important to you? So when you have a changing room in pontoon boats, your typical standard seating configuration is going to have a pad on the back, changing room, then the seat starts. Well, this feels a lot bigger inside than it is because of Harris's design. Harris and Crest got in a lawsuit over this, but this flips out of here, so you can put a little porta potty right here if you want to use it for that. But if you don't, it doesn't take up any room at all. It's just the bottom of the seat, so it really doesn't matter. You have a nice bimini top, and it shades from right here all the way to just above the helm. Actually, yeah, right above the helm. So that's a lot of shade. You can stand underneath it, leave it up while you're driving. Back in here, we put some junk in our trunk. To the port side, we got storage in the aft corner. Got a bunch of life jackets in there. Rear walkthrough door. Well, one thing you gotta like about this bimini top too is it has the quick disconnects. It doesn't have pins. You don't have to worry about dropping them in the lake. They just click in and unclick out. This is a gorgeous captain seat. Once again, with Harris, it's so confusing tri-tune shopping because there's so many brands out there, and every brand has to do something a little different. Bend it, break it, shake it, weld it. Do it differently to make it sound like it's the best thing for you. To me, it's all about the same, but it's really not. In terms of, there's so many models that, you know, can have nice upholstery and just built like complete junk underneath. Here's what to look for. This has a full-length center pontoon. It has a long shaft motor. It's a higher-end model for Harris in this year. It also has really nice, soft, plush, upgraded upholstery, upgraded from when it was new. It hasn't been reupholstered. It's all original. It's definitely a great model is what I'm really getting at here. So this captain seat, you won't want to get out of. Here we have our remote unit for our Yamaha. So this is our shifter. It's rated for 14 people. Beautiful helm. Now this boat we're going to list at $19,900, so it's a great value because we get a 150 Yamaha 4-stroke, meter read 621, that stays on when the key's on, runs perfectly. We'd have to scan it at the computer because I guarantee there's less. We got a little fish finder, CD stereo, a nice locking glove box, and this has some substance to it. Unlike a lot of them, if you just pull hard enough, it'll come right off. Plug our phone in here, speedometer, volt, trim gauge, tack, depth finder, fuel, meter, lights, we got it all. Well, thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel if you haven't. Check us out on usedboatstv.com, which will redirect you to firstphasemarine.com to see our listings. If you're interested in a trailer, Gladstone Cove Boat Trailer Sales.com is a long one, but we'll see you on the water. Just a good old boy.